Good morning, League of Legends. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a good Tuesday. Sean Hogan coming to you as a new member of the league. And going to drop some knowledge right now. I'm going to give you a little bit of insight on where I think the divisions will pan out, where I think the playoffs will pan out, who I'm picking preseason-wise as far as my favorites to win this thing. And then we're going to talk about week one a little bit, pretty brief. As you can see, this is all I need. I mean, just a couple little notes. All my knowledge is right here. So I went to CJ's and saw my girls over there at CJ's a little while ago. Took Scott in there with me and everything else, and sat down after he left and just put a few things together. They talked about different stuff, and every girl walked by. What are you doing? Sean, what are you doing? I said, well, fantasy football. I said, it's here. It's great. 2 days, folks. 2 days we start this thing. So I hope you're as fired up as I am, but let's just jump into this real quick. So let's talk divisions. All right, and I'm going to start out west. I'm going to start out here in the Western Division, probably the most lopsided division that I see. And we look at who's my pick to win that division. Well, my number one pick and my number one overall going into the playoffs, I think, is Scott and his bottom dwellers. Let's stop right there. My man has the best team in this league. Change your name. Bottom Dwellers is stupid. It's not a play on words. It's not witty. It's not fun. Change your name. Sucks. Change it. So, Bottom Dwellers, I see winning that division. Tyler and the more the merrier, I see coming in second. Let's stop and talk about Tyler. Tyler, I love you. I love you. But when you say, I need a tight end, and someone else says, hey, I have some tight ends, the trades just don't happen on their own. You actually got to send an offer out. Or you got to accept an offer that's sent. And I know it might not be up to standards, but at the same time, if you need a tight end, and I have three, come get one of them, please. Not the one named Pitts, though. The other two, fine, not Pitts. All right, and then building champions, you're dead last in that division. You're terrible. You're dead last in the league. You know that, though. That's why I respect you, Chris. You know your team sucks. You need a name change, too. Building champions, you need to put, like, building champions that might take 4 or 5 years. You just need to add to it. Or building a mediocre team that might turn into champions later on. So, that's my West. Swinging from the West, let's go down South now. In the South, my number two seed and who should get the second bye in the postseason is Prodigy. Steve has done some very good work. He sends out some crazy offers in the mornings, but guess what? He sends them out. And he sends them out, and he's worked his tail off to get his team where it needs to be. That pickup of Josh Allen, it took... Scott was always here for me in a tier by himself. I still think Scott's in that number one tier, but Steve put himself in the number two tier, and he's by himself. And he's really close to getting on him on the heels of Scott and everything else. So Steve, done good work. You are my number two seed going into the postseason. I think you get a bye, you and Scott both. You're going to win your division pretty easily. Now, swinging from... west to south, let's hit up the east. Let's hit up my division. Looking at it, just looking at the numbers, Kenny, I think you've got a little bit of an edge over the rest of us. I think you're predicted for about 26-80 as far as your points and everything else, where I'm coming in around 25-40 or something. So basically that's a good player. I'm still a good player away from you, all right? But I see you winning the east. Kenny Mack and everything else. I have you as my number four seed going into the postseason, though. I think you're number four. I think I come in second place. Steel Curtain, Bill, I think you come in just a little bit below me. Let me back up, actually, because I skipped after Prodigy. I didn't talk a whole lot about his division. In the South, Joe, I got you coming in second. And then Bert and the Big Sombrero, I got you coming in third. Bert, you got a little bit of work to do. I know you're all about it. You get stuff done. Still need to do a little bit more work. So in the South, I got Prodigy, then the Rebellion, then the Big Sombrero, and then swinging over to the East. Like I said, the Freak, the one and only Freak, And then myself with Team Hardware, and then the Steel Curtain. I think we finish in that order. But Kenny is my number four seed. So I've got one at Scott, two at Steve, four at Kenny. Then we're going to talk about the toughest division in this league. And I say toughest division because Darren and his swashbucklers are predicted to get 28-20 for the season. Well, good old cousin Austin, right behind him, is predicted to get 27-99. So we're talking a 21-point difference in these two guys. All right, I'm giving Darren the edge right now. Darren, you're my number three seed going into the postseason. The only reason why I'm giving you an edge is because you are the defending champ, which shows that you know how to get it done going into the postseason. You have the edge. But a little too many Bud Lights, just a little hiccup. One little hiccup, and Big A jumps over you, and Big A might be that number three seed going into the postseason. So, Darren, Big A, injury-prone Barry, look, I mean, you're tight there too, 2,500 points. 2,500 in my division almost puts you ahead of me. So, I mean, it's a very competitive division. Darren, I see you getting it. So, I was going to call Darren 3A and Austin 3B, but division winners get in. So, that's my four division winners. All right, Scott, number one seed, Steve, number two, Big D, number three, and then Kenny Mack, number four. Austin gets in the postseason, period. He's my number five, which basically means for our six playoffs positions, there are a bunch of us. A bunch of us. And I say us because I'm in there too. But there's a bunch of us trying to get that ever elusive number six seed. Right now, that's Tyler. The more the merrier. Predicted 27-57. I'm only predicted, like I said, 25-45. But Tyler, I'm on your heels. And if you don't make a trade and you don't get better and you don't try to improve your team, you're holding on to three quarterbacks like you can use all three of them. Trade somebody. Jalen Hurts, Russell Wilson, and then the molester who gets massages and touches ladies. You've got all three of them. Trade somebody. You're my sixth seed, though. You're making the playoffs right now. Those are the six in. There are four of us that are trailing you. I'm number one right behind you. This is no specific order, but I think I'm number one behind you. I'm right behind you. Bill's right behind me. All right, Bill's about 120 points off of me. The Rebellion and Joe, you're a little bit ahead of Bill according to the projections. So you're chasing too. And then injury prone, like I said. I mean, Barry's right there with us. So injury prone, Team Hardware, the Rebellion, and then like I said, Steel Curtain. So they're my six playoff teams. In look, I told you where everybody's finishing. If not for a hiccup or somebody holds on to players because they think three quarterbacks benefits them all year. But that's six, that's four. The other two at the bottom, Bert, you predicted 2,200 points. Got some work to do. I'm not being ugly, not being mean. I think you know that. Keep doing your thing, dude. Keep making trades. And then Chris, Chappie, I love you, buddy. I brought you in the league. You got a lot of work to do. All right, Scott, who's your week one matchup, I think you played him three times this year. Scott's predicted for almost 3,100 fantasy points. Your team, 1,900. That's six studs that Scott has on you, maybe even more. But look, got some work to do. So that's my six playoff teams. That's my four close on the bubble teams. And then, like I said, a couple that really need to work on something. All right, looking at this thing, Bottom Dwellers gets a bye, Prodigy gets a bye, my 3 and 6 seed. So, Darren, I got you playing more the merrier. Darren, you move on. All right, you're in the second round of the playoffs. All right, and then the one and only Freak and Big A. I think Big A could be number three instead of number five. So, Kenny, you're in my division, but I think Big A beat you. So, now I've got Scott against Big A, and Prodigy against Darren. I love the cousins. Love them. Big A and Darren Beards. I mean, y'all got it going on. You're not getting past those two teams right now. No, I mean, long season. Things change, you might do it. Right now, I have Prodigy and Bottom Dwellers, which is Again, a stupid name. Change it, Scott. It's dumb. But Bottom Dwellers and Prodigy in the championship, barring any injury, I think Scott comes out on top. All right, so that's my early preseason prediction for the way this league finishes up. Scott, if you have an injury at all and Josh Allen stays healthy for Steve, that's the only way you lose. So he told you yesterday in the text, you better pray for some health. You better pray for some health, buddy. All right, so that's my preseason. Let's look real fast at this week one matchup. And I haven't even looked at it, really. All I'm going to do is look at the matchups real quick and look at all the green. First team I go to, myself and Steel Curtain. All right, I'm predicted to win 53% to 47%. I didn't go to the scoring preview. I went to the scores. Please forgive me. Scoring preview. Let's look at our greens. Lamar Jackson over Cousins. Connor over Jacobs. Kareem Hunt over Patterson. I probably won't play Kareem Hunt. Who knows? Receivers are kind of the same, except for Godwin. If Godwin's not going to play or he's not 100%, he gets bumped out. I slide somebody else up in there. Bill, it's going to be a tight matchup. I'm going to beat you. So we're going to move on from that. I think I edged Bill. All right, Big Sombrero against the Rebellion. 148 to 147 is prediction there. Looking at it, Stafford and Rodgers. I think Stafford's better than Rodgers, even though CBS does not. Stafford's got weapons to throw to. Rodgers doesn't. Lazard's hurt all of a sudden. Watson's been hurt the preseason. Who's he throwing it to? Fufu the idiot circus clown? No. I think Matthew Stafford's better. Barkley. Ugh, I hate Barkley and the Barkley curse. It is real. So Fournette wins that one. Gibson. God, they wanted to give the guy that got shot the job anyway. Gibson is not good. So Nick Chubb gets it there. Receivers, I think I'm leaning more towards Hollywood Brown, Judy, Amon Ross, St. Brown. I don't know about that, but Cooper on the other side. So, look, 148 to 147. I'm calling this one in the coin toss. Bert, you're going to win that one. Get your first W of the year. Moving on. Prodigy, more the merrier. Probably don't even need to look at this. Oh, closer than I thought. 169 to 166. They had Jalen Hurts outscoring Josh Allen. CBS smoking crack? I mean, what's going on? I know Josh Allen is playing the Rams, but come on. Josh Allen's going to get his. All right, Derrick Henry, I think, beats Mixon. I definitely like Cook better than Pierce, but that was a great pickup for you with Pierce, Tyler. Cooper Kupp. My little Cooper Kupp. I think I give the wide receiver edge to Tyler, the more the merrier. But then when we look at defense, Steve's defense is just stupid good. Steve's going to win that in a close one. So I'm going with Prodigy in week one. And then the Cousins. We start off with Austin against Darren in week one. 169 to 164 is what CBS has. I don't know if you can see all the green right there, but all that green, all this, for the offensive people, is on Darren's side. Darren, love you, buddy. Austin, love you too, buddy. Y'all are tight. It's going to be tight all year. And I love it that y'all play each other three times. That will probably be the key to who wins your division. If one person wins two, the other person wins one. Whoever wins two out of three, I think, wins that division. I mean, like I said earlier, you could be 3A and 3B. I'm going to give this week one edge, though, over to Justin Herbert, Austin Eckler, Kamara, Justin Jefferson, Jamar Chase, Juju Smith-Schuster, which who knows what Juju will do with Patrick Mahomes, but I'm giving it the D right now. Next, we have Steel Curtain and Hardware. I'm predicted to win by four. Lamar Jackson, I like more than Cousins. Connor Jacobs, I've already done mine. Why am I doing this again? Injury prone in the freak show. My apologies. 161 to 147. The only thing that they have predicted that you win with Barry and injury prone, they got Kyler Murray by 2 points over Dak Prescott, and they got Javonte Williams by 2 points over Cam Akers. But everything else is in favor of the freak show. So Kenny picks up his first win representing my division. Go ahead and pick it up and move on. And then I think the last game, why? Scott, 177. Chris, 113. I'm not even talking about that anymore. So we're going to move on from that. So Vixen Barrel Rebellion, I did that. Prodigy, More the Merrier, did it. The Cousins, which is my game of the week, I just did that one. Steel Curtain, me, I tried to do it twice. Freak moves on. Bottom Dwellers gets an easy win. I think Scott could take half his lineup and I'll still win. So, guys, that's your week one. Football is here. It's here. It's time to play. It's time to play the game. Look, have a great week. I look forward to hearing the comments from this video. Good luck, guys. Good luck. And Tyler, you better get better because I'm coming for you. Y'all have a good day. Thanks.